Good morning students, in this lecture 23rd of mechanics we will discuss that what is the effect of centrifugal force which arises due to the rotation of earth on the acceleration due to gravity. So here the centrifugal force, as we all know that it arises due to the rotation of earth. Now we will check that what is the effect of centrifugal force on the acceleration due to gravity, that is small g. So for that, here we are considering the earth. This is the earth and it is rotating about z axis with angular velocity vector omega vector in anti-clockwise direction. It is rotating in this way, in the direction opposite to that of the clock, the hands of the clock. So here we have considered that earth, it is rotating about z axis in anti-clockwise direction, in this direction with angular velocity omega vector. So what will be the value of this omega vector? We know that any vector, it is equal to its magnitude multiplied by the unit vector, because unit vector tells us about the direction, because its magnitude is unity, that is one. That is why it is known as a unit vector. A vector having magnitude is equal to 1, that is unity and direction. So omega vector, it will be equal to its magnitude, which is omega, into what is the direction? It will be given by its unit vector. And we know that the direction of omega vector, it is along z axis. And what is the unit vector along z axis? It is k cap. So it will be omega into k cap. And suppose this as equation number 1. Now consider any particle of mass small m. It is lying at this point P, and this point P is at the surface of the earth. So then we have considered that we have a particle of mass small m which lies at point P, and this point P, it is on the surface of the earth. And the angle of latitude is lambda, means the angle of the position vector of the particle with equator, it is lambda, which is known as latitude. So latitude is lambda. Now suppose that this particle, it lies in yz plane. This particle, it lies in yz plane. Then what will be the position vector of the particle if it lies in yz plane? Suppose r vector is the position of position vector of particle, which is given by op vector. And what will be its value? As this particle, it lies in yz plane, so we will find the components of r vector along y axis and along z axis. So what will be the component of r vector along y axis? The unit vector along y axis is j cap, and this r vector, it makes an angle lambda with this y axis. So the component will be cos component, it will be r cos lambda. How? Draw the perpendicular from point P on y axis, then you will get right angle triangle in this way. When you will draw a perpendicular on y axis, suppose this point is n, this is lambda, its magnitude is r. So what will be the component? This is the component along y axis, on, it will be r cos lambda. And what will be the component in this perpendicular direction, pn? It will be r sin lambda. And this is pn, it is parallel to z axis. So the component of r vector along z axis will be r sin lambda. So the component of r vector in the direction of y axis, it is r cos lambda. It is the magnitude of that component. What will be the direction of this component? It is along positive y axis, means j cap, plus the component of r vector along z axis, which is r sin lambda. इंटू इट्स डायरेक्शन विच इज गिवन बाय द यूनिट वेक्टर एंड द डायरेक्शन ऑफ यूनिट वेक्टर द यूनिट वेक्टर अलोंग जेड एक्सिस इज के कैप. सो दिस इज द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ द पोजिशन वेक्टर ऑफ द पार्टिकल विच लाइज एट द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ एंड इन वाई जेड प्लेन. नाउ वट विल बी द यूनिट वेक्टर इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ आर वेक्टर. There is always a unit vector in the direction of any vector. So what is the unit vector in the direction of r vector? We know that any unit vector, it is equal to a vector divided by its magnitude. You have already studied this in your 10 plus 1. So what is the value of r vector? It is, take r common from here, equation number 2. So it will be cos lambda j cap plus sin lambda k cap divided by r. So this r and r will be cancelled out. So the value of r cap is cos lambda j cap plus sin lambda k cap. And suppose this as equation 3. Next is, what are the forces acting on the particle at point P? So see, as this particle P, it lies on the surface of Earth, and we know that Earth exerts the gravitational force on every object which lies at its surface or near the surface. So because of the force of gravity, Earth will exert a force on this point P, and which is known as weight of the particle. So the first force which will act on the particle which lies at point P on the surface of Earth, it is the weight of the particle. Because Earth will exert gravitational force on this particle towards its center. Earth will attract this particle towards its center. So the weight of the particle at point P, it will act towards the center of the Earth. It means the direction of this force due to weight, it is PO vector. Means opposite to that of r vector. So the first force acting on the particle is at point P is the weight of the particle which is acting towards the center of the earth, that is along PO vector, opposite to r vector, because r vector is OP vector due to the gravitational force. So it will be equal to mass into acceleration. Mass is m. What is acceleration? It is acceleration due to gravity, which is g. And acceleration due to gravity, it acts along PO vector. So it will be m, any vector, it is equal to its magnitude into its direction. And its direction is given by PO unit vector. And this PO unit vector, it is in the direction opposite to that of r cap. R cap, it is in the direction of r vector, and PO vector, its direction is opposite. So its direction is of minus r cap. So this F1 vector, it is equal to m into g into minus r cap. This implies F1 vector, it is equal to minus mg r cap, and from equation 3rd, put the value of r cap. It is equal to minus mg cos lambda j cap plus sin lambda k cap. So the first force which is acting on the particle which lies on the surface of the earth due to the weight of the particle or due to the force of gravity exerted by Earth on the particle towards its center, and it is equal to minus mg cos lambda j cap plus sin lambda k cap. And this negative sign, it indicates that, suppose this is equation A, this negative sign indicates that the direction of this force due to weight, it is towards the center of the Earth, means opposite to that of r vector. Now, what will be the second force acting on the particle at point P? Because Earth is in continuously rotational motion. So earth is a rotating frame of reference, and in rotating frame of reference there will centrifugal force acting on that particle. So the other force which will be acting at point P on that particle, it will be the centrifugal force. And we know that the expression for centrifugal force is, suppose it is F2 vector and it is equal to minus M omega cross R. This is the formula for centrifugal force. But what is the exact expression of centrifugal force in this case? We can calculate that by putting the values of omega vector from equation 1 and R vector from equation 2. So put the values. It is minus M. Omega vector is omega into k cap cross. Omega vector is again omega into k cap cross product with R vector. What is the value of R vector? It is R cos lambda j cap plus R sin lambda k cap. Now watch these steps carefully. So F2 vector, which is the centrifugal force, it will be equal to minus M. As you can see, this R, it is a scalar quantity and it is common from this bracket. So take it outside. This omega and this omega, both are scalar quantities because they don't have vector sign with them. So omega and omega, you can take them outside the bracket and it will be omega into omega will be omega square. So inside the bracket we have this k cap cross product with this k cap, its cross product with cos lambda j cap plus sin lambda k cap. Now solve this. First of all, we will solve this part. How? See, F2 vector, it is equal to minus M R omega square k cap, its cross product with this cos lambda, it is a scalar quantity. So write it as it is, and here we will have k cross j. Then k cross with sin lambda k, this sin lambda is a scalar quantity, so write it as it is. Here we will have k cross k, k cap cross k cap. And now we know that k cross k cap cross k cap, this you have studied in your 10 plus 1 and in your electricity and magnetism, that this k cap cross k cap, it is equal to 0. Why? Because angle between the unit vector with itself is 0. And a cross b, it is equal to ab sin theta. So if theta is 0, sin 0 will be 0, which will make cross product of these two vectors is equal to 0. And this k cross j, it is equal to minus I cap. This k cross j, it is equal to minus I cap, because j cross k is I cap and k cross j is minus I cap. So here we will have F2 is equal to minus M R omega square k cap cross product with cos lambda. Move this minus sign here, cos lambda I cap. And here we have 0, because 0 into sin lambda will be 0. And this minus and minus will be plus. So M R omega square, cos lambda is scalar quantity, so write it as it is. And here we have cross product of k cap with I cap. And this cross product, it is equal to j cap. So this implies the centrifugal force acting on the particle at point P, which lies on the surface of Earth, it is equal to m r omega square cos lambda j cap. And suppose this is equation number B. Now this is m r omega square cos lambda. This is the magnitude of centrifugal force. And this j cap tells us about the direction of centrifugal force. J cap is the unit vector along y axis. It means centrifugal force is acting on the particle along positive y axis. So this implies centrifugal force F2, it is acting on the particle at point P along positive y axis, means it will act in this direction. Centrifugal force will act in this direction, and the force due to weight, it is acting towards the center in the direction opposite to r vector. So these are the two forces acting on the particle because of the rotational motion of Earth. So what will be the total force acting on the particle at point P? So the total force we will get by adding equation A and B. By adding equation A and B, we get the total force or net force acting on the particle at point P. So it will be, suppose total force acting on the particle is F dash. Why we are taking it as F dash? Because Earth is rotating frame. It will be equal to the sum of two forces, the force due to weight or the force due to gravity and the force centrifugal force. So put the values from equation A and B in this equation. F1 is minus mg into cos lambda j cap plus sin lambda k cap. This is the value of force due to gravity, plus the value of F2 is from equation B, it is mr omega square cos lambda j cap. So now from this equation, as you can see, these two terms have cos lambda j cap in common. So take cos lambda j cap common from these two terms. So you will have F dash vector, it is equal to minus mg cos lambda plus mr omega square cos lambda. This is having j cap common, and next term is minus mg sin lambda k cap. Minus mg sin lambda k cap. And suppose this as equation number C. Now, due to the rotational motion of Earth, its origin O, it is shifted to O dash. Means it feels like its origin is actually not O, it is O dash because of its rotational motion. So due to the rotation of Earth, its origin O, it gets shifted to this point O dash. It means the force due to the net force, it is not acting, or the force due to gravity, it is not acting in this direction, it is actually acting in this direction. So the effective acceleration due to gravity, it is not along PO vector, but it is along PO dash vector. It means the value of G changes because of the rotation of Earth. The value of acceleration due to gravity G, it changes due to the rotation of Earth, because of which it feels like that the origin or the center of the earth, it is not at point O, but it is at point O dash. So in that case, this F dash, due to the rotation of earth, because its origin is shifted from O to O dash, so the effective acceleration due to gravity, it will be G dash instead of G. So this F dash, it will be equal to mg dash. And suppose this is equation D, and from equation, suppose this is G dash vector, from equation C and D, because left hand sides are same, so right hand sides will also be equal. So from equation C and D, equating right hand sides, we will get mg dash, it is equal to minus mg cos lambda plus m omega square r cos lambda j cap minus mg sin lambda k cap. And here you can see m is common because m is there in all the three terms on right hand side. M is there in all the three terms on right hand side. Then take this m common, and this m, it will be cancelled out with this m. You have to write one step here, that take this m common from all these three terms, write it here outside the bracket, and then cancel it with this. So now we have g dash vector, it is equal to minus g cos lambda plus omega square r cos lambda into j cap minus g sin lambda into k cap. So this is the effective acceleration due to gravity, effective value of acceleration due to gravity because of the rotation of earth. So the value of g is not same on the surface of earth, it changes because of its rotation. Now what will be its magnitude? So magnitude of any vector, it will be equal to the square root and the square of the coefficient of j cap, because if you have r vector is equal to xi cap plus yj cap, then what is the magnitude of r? It is square root of coefficient of I cap is x square plus coefficient of j cap is y, so y square. In the same way here, the coefficient of j cap is this. So square of this term, which is minus g cos lambda plus omega square r cos lambda, and plus we have this term, coefficient of k cap is minus g sin lambda, so square of this. Now solve this. Here we have, this is A minus this is B. A minus B whole square. It is equal to A square, means omega 4 R square cos square lambda, plus B square minus 2 AB. So it will be omega square R G, cos into cos will be cos square lambda. And here we have G square sin square lambda. Now from these two terms you can see g square is common, so g dash, it is equal to, this is square root, g square is common, and inside the bracket you will have cos square lambda plus sin square lambda, and this is equal to 1 identity. Then this term, omega 4 r square cos square lambda. Then this term, g square sin square lambda. Now next step is to take this g square common. As you can see here in the second term, we don't have any g square. So multiply it by g square and divide it by g square. Now take g square common. And when you will take that g square outside the square root, it will be g. So you have taken g square common from this bracket, then you have taken that g square outside this square root, and you will get g. So g square, it has been taken common, this is equal to 1, so here we have 1. Plus here this g square is taken common, so here we have term omega 4 r square cos square lambda upon g square, and here this g square is taken common, so here we have plus this term and this term we have taken common, this term was meant to be written here. So here we have minus 2 omega square r g cos square lambda, and we have to take g square common, but here we only have g, so multiply it by g, so g into g will be g square, divide it by g, so we have taken this g square common, so here we will have minus 2 omega square r cos square lambda upon g and square root. So now in the previous lecture we have obtained the value of omega, which is 7.27 into 10 raised to power minus 5 radian per second. Means the value of this omega, it was very small. If omega is very small, then omega 4, it will be very very smaller than omega. So this term, it will be approximately equal to 0. Because the value of omega is very small, so omega square will be smaller than omega. Omega cube will be smaller than omega square, and omega 4 will be even smaller than omega. So that is why we can ignore this term. So we are only left with g dash, it is equal to g 1 minus 2 omega square r upon g cos square lambda raised to power 1 by 2. Here again, as you can see, we have omega square. So this term, it is less than 1. And whenever we have 1 plus x raised to power n and this x is less than 1, then we use binomial theorem, and according to binomial theorem, it will be equal to 1 plus nx. According to binomial theorem. So here also we will use binomial theorem. So according to binomial theorem, we have g dash, it is equal to g 1 plus, what is the value of n? Power is 1 by 2 here, into x is minus 2 omega square r by g cos square lambda. So this 2 and 2 will be cancelled out. So we have g dash, it is equal to, multiply this g inside the bracket, g into 1 will be g, minus this g and this g will be cancelled out, so we have this. What does this mean? That due to the rotation of earth, centrifugal force act on the particle, and because of the centrifugal force which arises due to the rotation of earth, the value of acceleration due to gravity changes. As any particle, it moves on the surface of the earth, the value at every point, the value of g is different. And it is equal to g minus omega square r cos square lambda. Now, first case is, if the particle is at the poles, south pole and north pole. Suppose this is Earth. If the particle is at the poles, it means either the particle is at this north pole or the particle is at this south pole. Then lambda, what will be the value of lambda? It is the angle with the equator. So lambda in this case, it will be 90 degree, and lambda in this case will also be 90 degree. So if the particle is at the poles, then lambda is 90 degree. It means cos lambda will be 0 because it is cos 90. In that case, g dash will be equal to g minus 0, which is z. So at the poles, the value of acceleration due to gravity remains the same. It means there is no effect of the centrifugal force or the rotation of earth for the object which lies at the poles, because at the poles the force of gravity remains same. G dash is equal to G, that is the standard value of G, 9.8 meter per second square. But if the particle is at the equator, if the particle is present at the equator, means either at this point or at this point. Suppose the particle is at this point, then the angle of the position vector with equator, it is 0 degree, lambda will be 0 in that case. So if lambda is 0, then cos lambda, which is equal to cos 0 degree, it will be equal to 1. Put cos lambda equal to 1 here, g dash will be equal to g minus omega square r here. It means when the particle lies at the equator on this equatorial line, at that time the value of acceleration due to gravity is minimum. And when the particle lies at poles, the value of acceleration due to gravity is maximum. It means as we move from on the surface of Earth, as we move from the equator to the poles, the value of acceleration due to gravity increases from minimum to maximum, means it increases. But as anyone will move from poles to equator, the value of acceleration due to gravity will decrease. From equator to poles, the value of acceleration due to gravity increases, and from poles to equator, the value of acceleration due to gravity decreases. Because of the rotation of Earth, centrifugal force is acting, and because of that, the acceleration due to gravity